Here I am at RJ's Meats in Hudson, Wisconsin. What a great place to come to find some treasures that you can't find anywhere else. I'm looking forward to meeting Rick. He's a master meat crafter, and he has many different stories to share and the history of what his company is. So we will be here checking it out, and I will show you some of the products that he has created. Cheese sticks, that's one of my favorites. There's a little sign of all the different things that he has.
These are the greatest ham sticks I've ever had.
Selection of many different products in this fresh meat case. One of them is the Cajun style that I really
love. To you daily, what a man really is. I lay down my life loving you.
We are in the back room where they're packaging some of the summer sauce that they're making, and they just bought a new machine to package everything. They have all kinds of different products. What is this, Grandpa Jim's?
This is Grandpa Jim's, named after one of our customers who had asked for a summer sausage with no garlic.
We are at RJ's Meats in Hudson, and we're with master meat crafter Rick Reams, alias RJ. And just really privileged to be here with a man of so much knowledge and expertise in this business. And Rick, I'd just like you to share a little bit about how you got started and what things in the industry that you really enjoy and some of the products that you offer that are have been your great award winners.
Okay, well, been in business for nearly 28 years, and when I bought the business from the previous owner, we were strictly fresh meats, and that was back in the late 80s. Everybody was really health conscious, and we needed to do something more, and so we took on smoking meats, and I knew nothing about it, and had a lot of help from a lot of other great butchers throughout Wisconsin and Minnesota and Illinois and a few from Indiana and Nebraska and basically all over the country. And that was 20 some years ago that they started helping me out, and today we do a full line of smoked and cooked products also along with our fresh sauce.
And now people are coming to you asking you for the advice and for help on doing things.
Now I get the phone calls and I look at it as somebody help me and whatever I can help them with.
Yep.
I do. Yep. We do our own bacons, hams, over 50 different flavors of bratwurst.
Wow.
Close to a dozen and a half flavors of summer sausage, 12, 14 flavors of snack sticks. Recently, within the last decade, started making a dry cured product. So now we do a Italian salami with wine that we've won numerous awards with, and I have a few other stores that actually sell that product along with us now. And won our first Best of Show award.
Wow.
For the state of Wisconsin with that product. When I first started making it, it would take about 3 months to make it.
Wow.
Now I've got it down to just about a month-long process with the aid of a drying chamber that I imported from Italy.
And you went right over there and found that, didn't you? Or?
I actually found a distributor here that,
okay.
That reps that company, but I 3 years ago traveled to Germany to international trade show, and I looked at various makes and models and made my mind up from there.
Yep.
And so we do an Italian salami with wine. We do a Finocchiona, a classic salami, a green pepper corn salami, sopressata, which is my personal favorite, but it's pretty hot. It's made with imported Italian chili pepper paste.
Okay.
We also make a colpa.
That's one of my favorites, colpa.
Yeah, colpa is one of my favorites. I've loved it forever. I was reading up on it, but hey, as I've done so many other times, I can make this.
You can make that and perfect it.
Yeah, when I started, I said, we're going to make two or three things, we're going to make them really good.
Yep.
Yeah, well, that was not one of my success stories, because right now, we've probably got over 500 different formulations for products.
Wow. Okay,
and that's not two or three. And we try to make everything as good as we can, because Hudson's population is right around 13,000. When we moved to this town when I was 11 years old, it was about 6,000. So I know a lot of people in town.
Yep.
Take a lot of pride in the fact that they come to us as we're their local worship.
Yeah.
And that means a lot to me. I don't want to be the next George Cornell or anything like that.
Yep.
I want to serve this community. And so I want to give them as many different products as we can, because everybody gets tired of eating the same thing over and over.
Yeah.
So Copa was one that has come on, and there's a lot of people that are really enjoying it. I've had a number of states, that's what they've ever had.
Well, and that's something that I've done over the years, is to get, I find, put things in your shop, and Rick and I have worked together for many, many years, and always have found it a place to recommend for people to go from Eau Claire or even southern Wisconsin, anywhere. And now with the internet, that people across the country can order your product. So is that hold true?
We ship products to Florida, to New York, Montana, Washington, California, Texas, and all points in between.
Yeah, fantastic. Could you share your story of the Osman label?
Well, that's an interesting one. So my last name is Reeves. Pretty generic, as my dad always said, we're mutts, we're Heinz 57. ancestors that were asked to leave the French church, which is commonly known as the Quakers, because they fought the American Revolution.
Okay.
And there's been many different bloodlines infused into my surname.
Well,
one of the most recent was in the mid-1800s, John Osman and William Osman immigrated from Bavaria, Germany, sausage makers, to Ohio, settled in Columbus. And John was the grandfather to my grandmother, Matilda Osman, my dad's mother.
Okay.
And I didn't know any of this until 10, 15 years ago.
Okay.
And my sister had sent me a clipping in our hometown in Ohio, as they were celebrating their Festival Centennial, or one of the big celebrations, that the Osmond's Meat Palace was the place to go at the turn of the 20th century if you wanted the best lard and some of the best sausages.
Okay.
And so her maiden name was Osman. And when I was in Germany, I actually visited a village unknown to me at the time, didn't even know where we were headed as on a tour, called Osman's House.
Okay.
And so it's... We always joke in the meat industry that once this gets in your blood, you're done.
Yep.
You know, it's like an addiction. You
got
to do this stuff. Well, here I find out that my great 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 grandfather was a Bavarian sausage maker.
Wow.
He lost it. To that end, my sons are in business with me, and they think they're not real thrilled when I say, in case I tip over.
Yep.
Because I always say, never buy from a skinny butcher.
Yep, I agree.
Look at a guy that looks like he's 90% hot, which my levels are good.
Yeah.
But so I write everything down. All my recipes are written down, and any particular steps that I take, I share with the boys. So if something could happen, one day it will.
Yep.
But they'll they'll take over, but they won't miss a step, and they'll probably do a lot better job than I do.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's one thing I noticed on your website with being a craft, and a craft, each one is a craft, and how it's not mass-produced, and each one can have just a little bit difference in the way it's made. Could you go more into that a little bit?
Sure. Every animal is an individual. Every muscle structure that they have is an individual. Each animal eats different. You have to be able to look at that and recognize what it's going to be, what we can use it for, how we can best utilize it. Is it going to be too lean for this? Do we need to add more fat to make this crop?
Yep.
Do we need to lean it up? Everything takes salt different. The first time that I made sausage after I bought the shop, I said, man, I'm going to give these people some of the best Italian sausage they've ever had in their lives.
Yeah.
And I brought in nice lean meat because this was the late 80s, and everybody was all about lean. And I made some of the leanest Italian sausage that you could ever hope for. And it looked beautiful. I mean, it was red, and it looked juicy, and it was just bright. And I thought, wow, they're going to love this. And it sold out nothing flat because it was great.
Yep.
I made 50 pounds of it, and I am sure I refunded 75 pounds of it. It was...
No flavor, huh?
No flavor. You got a little bit of fat to carry the flavor in those products. And that was where I kind of began to learn that, well, sometimes you got to do... Everything is an individual. You have to look at it and for what it is.
Yep. Fantastic. What do you have here on the rack next to
you? This is our famous slab bacon. We make and smoke all of our bacon here in our store. Wisconsin hardwoods that we smoke with, and our bacon has won grand champion at the Wisconsin State Fair 6 times.
Wow.
And we kind of felt we were taking advantage of people by hearing so often, so I don't enter that petition anymore. I said that to one gentleman from Minnesota one time. And he told me, I said, Steve, I'm kind of bummed that you're judged.
Yep.
But not really, because now that means that there's room for me to jump in there and get some awards. And this was 20 plus years ago when I didn't have any awards.
Yeah.
And he said, Rick, he says, I don't look at it that way. He says, if I stop competing, does the level of competition, the level of product drop in, the level of competition? And he is right. But it's one of those things where it's just, it comes at an inconvenient time for us to enter it now. But we sell a lot of bacon. We slice it to order when the customer wants it to go.
And you have different flavors too, don't you? You have different smokes, different things like that?
Yeah, we do our traditional with the hickory smoke.
Okay.
We're working on one with a beechwood smoke. It'll add a totally different flavor to that. We do a black pepper bacon. We do a 5 pepper bacon.
Oh, what pepper? What do you do with it?
It's a blend of black pepper, white pepper, jalapeno pepper, and a few other peppers. It's not really overpowering, but I want the taste buds to dance. I don't want to be body slammed.
Yep. Yep. And that's something that you've been really good at with the one thing that one product I've had of yours is the Anthony's Red Hot Sweetie. And
hey,
it would be a good thing for me to make for supper tonight.
How about sausage? Sauerkraut.
Oh, wow. That sounds great. And I can get both of them right here at RJ's?
Right here.
Fantastic. And do you have buns here, too?
We do have buns.
You do?
Right here, in fact.
I heard the Reams have got the best buns in town.
Well.
And it's so sweet at the beginning, and it finishes off that it has a real intense warm heat to it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
And a funny story on that product, we had won 3 of 4 classes grand champion in Wisconsin.
Okay.
And St. Paul Penny the Press got a hold of it, and we were running out of products. Well, at that point in time, I only had 80-some different formulations for different sausages.
Yep.
Well, they had printed that it had 80 flavors of bratwurst.
Oh, boy.
I had calls from all around the Midwest.
Yep.
And people wanting these products, and I had emergency deliveries of pork coming in so that we could make brats. We couldn't even keep up what we had. I read it, and customers were saying, I read that you've got 80 flavors of brats.
Yeah.
And I told all the employees, you guys got to start coming up with stuff, because we don't have 80 flavors. At that time, we were in the 20s.
Yeah.
I said, you guys got to get after it. And so that was one of Anthony's. that he came up with was the Red Hot Sweet. He could come up with a name for it, you know. It was just, you know, like a Red Hot with Sweet. And I,
yeah.
You got to be fanciful with some stuff. So we call it a Red Hot Sweet. Now, his wife, she's not so, I don't think she's overly fond of that. But it's, it was fun, you know. I was driving home from work with my second oldest on that Saturday that everything was breaking loose. And he said, yeah, I've never heard so many people with accents come in the store before. And one of my favorite stories was there's an older German gentleman came over, and he said, are you the proprietor? And I said, yeah, I'm RJ, I'm the owner. He says, I read in the newspaper, you have 80 flavors of brats. And he puts his arm around me, and he takes his other arm, and he says, and I see you piecing them up, too.
What a great story. Yep, yep. So what does it mean to you, just looking at your whole family being in here? You know, at some point in time they've worked in here, and I think three of your boys are working in here now, correct? And Ann's working here, your wife?
My wife, my three boys, I come from a family with five kids.
Yep.
Sorry.
It's good.
At one point in time, all the nieces and nephews have worked here. It was a dream of my dad's.
Okay.
I have a family business. He passed away 3 years ago.
Yeah.
But you got to see it. Means a lot.
Yeah. And just looking at the things that you've created, you can just tell that the passion and just the way that you've represented the whole industry has been way of life for you, and you know how we get connected with parents and family and just want to do them proud. And when I look at this whole operation, that's what I see in it, that's what I taste in it. And so anyway, I just really appreciate you taking the time to do this. And if you could just share a little bit more about your boys and just your family. I'm sorry, I got a little bit distracted. So
it's all right. My eldest Anthony, he's also gone through the Master Meat Craft program at University of Wisconsin-Madison and has earned the designation Master Meat Crafter also.
Okay.
And he's our NASA coordinator. He really has a passion for food safety.
Yep.
And of course, he's a heck of a chef. He can cook circles around me, which is almost mandatory nowadays. We always had to tell people how to cook, but now they want interesting ways. And he, man, from brisket to anything, he can, you know, oxtail soup to fancy stuff. He's our man. That's awesome. That's great. Aaron is my second oldest, and he's a student at University of River Falls. He's working in the business right now. He's going to college, economics and finance, double major, and he'll probably be leaving the family business, but
coming back
around as a consultant.
Yep.
You know, over time. My youngest Joe is graduated high school 2 years ago. And he's just a natural here too. They grew up in it. They remember the long nights where Dad was gone in the fall, where I'd be making venison sausage, cutting deer. He even helped us cut deer one night.
I've been there. Yep, I was there. Yep.
And but they remember that, and they really take ownership. There's a lot of pride in them. Same with my two nephews that work here. One, Cody, the full-time cutter.
Okay.
And Roger, who's my packaging manager at the present time. And it's awesome being able to work with family. And, you know, it's never a smooth road. It never will be.
Yep.
But, it's very satisfying.
Yeah, and one thing I've noticed growing up, and on my website, it'll say different things about the local community and how things come together. When I look at the old farms and stuff that I grew up around, and it was never a job. It was a lifestyle. And do you feel that way about this business?
When you think of it as a job, you lose in the battle.
Yep.
And there's times I thought it was a job, but you know it's 7 days a week for me.
Yep.
You know, we open up at 11 o'clock on Sundays, but typically on 7 o'clock mass, get done there, and we come in here, and there's a lot of times, if it's slow, I just have a cup of coffee and walk it up to the store and take it all in, and of course, the brain never stops trying to figure out how we can improve it.
Yeah.
And that's the attitude that my boys take, too. Something finishes in the smokehouse in the middle of the night, and these get put into the cooler,
yep.
any one of us has no problem.
They can come and
do it because it's just, you know, it's pretty cool to be able to provide for this community.
Yep.
I moved to town in 1972 when I was 11 years old, and one of the first things I did was got paper off. And I still have a few of those old customers that I used to deliver paper to.
You do.
Come in and shop and place and to see when one passes on.
But yeah.
It's been awesome.
Yep. And what about your wife, Ann? She's in here too, right?
Ann works too, yep. She is my HR personnel.
Okay.
And she heads up our cashiers and does a fantastic job as PR out front.
Yeah.
A lot of times we're in back making sausage or taking care of satisfying the paperwork for what's needed for trace back and everything else. And but she's out front. And
that's one thing.
Everybody knows Ann.
Yeah, and that's what I noticed. First thing you walk in, what a great smile, what a great personality to have greeting all the people that come in here. And that's one thing I notice about shopping at a local butcher shop is you come in and you get to know the customers. You know their things that they like. You're always willing to be able to bring out a new creation that you have and let people have a little taste of it. And usually they're addicted to it right after they taste it. So. But anyway, well, I sure appreciate you taking this time to meet with
my pleasure.
And hopefully we have some people that are coming to your site, checking things out, and bringing some great products home to their families. So.